Hello everybody and welcome to my channel The A2ist. Here we learn English with joy. Now this is our second video on the topic learning voice change, and let's see what are there for us today. So today we are going to learn first some basic rules of voice change. Next comes the voice change of verbs with auxiliary verb before them. Next comes the voice change of verbs in continuous tense. Next comes those objects that are generally not used as subjects in the passive form. And finally comes the voice change of verbs in transitive. Now, let's start with the basic rule. See, for example, in active voice, the general pattern of a sentence is SVO. That means first comes the subject, then comes the verb, and finally comes the object. Now, if we convert it into passive, first comes the object, then comes a be verb, then comes the past participle form of the main verb, then comes a by, and finally comes the subject. Now see, in the passive form, the be verb will be according to the tense of the main verb in the given sentence or in the active voice of, and the number and person of the object. Now take the example. Number one, Ram plays football. Now in this sentence, the verb is plays and its subject is Ram and the object is football. Now the verb plays is in present tense and the object football is a third person and singular number that we know. So let's convert it. First comes the object football. As football is a third person and singular number and the verb is in present, it takes a be verb is with it. Next comes the PP form of the main verb, play, played, played. Then comes a by, and finally the subject Ram. Now in the next example, he killed a snake. Here the verb is killed and it is in past tense. Its subject is he and its object is a snake. Now change the voice. First comes the object, a snake. Then comes the be verb in past tense, was. Then comes the PP form of the main verb, killed. Then comes a by and finally the subject, him. Now take the note. In example 1, the verb is in present tense and the object is in third person singular in number. So in passive voice, it takes the be verb is with it. And in example 2, the verb is in past tense and the object is a third person and singular number. So in passive, it takes the be verb was with it. See, while changing the voice of these type of sentences, we sometimes face a bit problems. Now we will discuss about all those problems. Now, problem 1. Some verbs do not take by after them in their passive form. See, for example, his conduct annoyed me. Now, the passive of this sentence will be, I was annoyed at his conduct. Here, the at is very important. See, the verb annoyed doesn't take a by with it in the passive form. It takes at with it. Now in the next example, you can see, I know him. Here the passive form is, he is known to me. So now it is quite clear that the know verb doesn't take a by with it in the passive, rather it takes a to with it. Now in the third example, see, smoke filled the room. Here the passive form is, the room was filled with smoke. Now come to the fourth example, this news will please you. Now its passive form will be, you will be pleased with the news. Now have a look at the problem 2. In active voice, if the subject is a negative indefinite pronoun, in passive the verb becomes negative and the subject is not used as object in the passive voice. Now have a look at the examples. Example 1, nobody expects me here. See, here the verb is expects and its subject is nobody. And that subject is obviously a negative indefinite pronoun. Now see how we convert it into passive. I am not expected here. So as the subject here was a negative indefinite pronoun, in passive, the verb turns into negative. These type of negative indefinite pronouns are not used as objects in the passive form. Now example 2, nobody saw him going out. Here the passive will be, he was not seen going out. Now take the note. In case such pronouns are positive, let's see what happens. Example 1, somebody expects me here. Now the passive is, I am expected here. Now example 2, somebody saw him going out. The passive is, he was seen going out. Well, now come to the second point. Here we are going to learn the voice change of verbs with some auxiliary verb before them. Note. The modal auxiliaries, we know the modal auxiliaries such as can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, dare, must, need, etc. All these verbs are called modal auxiliaries, and these verbs take a be with them in their passive form. Now, take the example. I can do this. Here the subject is I, the verb is can do, and the object is this. And in the verb section, can is the modal auxiliary and do is the main verb. So, the passive form will be, first comes the object, this, then can be, then the past participle form of the main verb, done, then comes a by, and finally, the subject here in its objective form, I turns into me. Now take the next example, you must respect him. Here the auxiliary is must, and we know that in passive, it will become must be. So, the passive form is, he must be respected by you. Now take the note. But if the auxiliary verb is a have verb, it takes a been with it in the passive form. See, the have verbs are three in number. In present tense, there are two, have and has. And in the past tense, it has only one form, had. Have a look at the examples. First, I have bought a pen. Here, I is the subject, the verb is have bought, and a pen is the object. Here, have is an auxiliary, and the main verb is bought. And we know that the have verbs take a been with them in the passive form. So the answer is, a pen has been bought by me. In the next example, see, he has bought three books. Here the subject is he, the verb is has bought, and the object is three books. Now, has is the auxiliary and bought is the main verb. Look, here the object is a third person and plural in number. So first comes the object, three books. And as the object is plural in number, it takes a have verb with it. Now comes the been, now the past participle form of the main verb bought, now comes a by, and finally the subject he turns into him here. And the final example, he had done the job, here the subject is he, verb is had done, and job, the job is the object. Here had is the auxiliary and done is the main verb. So the passive form is the job had been done by him. Now let's start with our next point. Here we are going to learn the voice change of the verbs in the continuous tense. See, in the active voice, the form is, first comes the subject, then the be verb, then a verb plus ing, then the object. And in the passive voice, the sentence construction is, first comes the object, then comes the be verb, then comes a being, then the past participle form of the main verb, then a by, and finally the subject. Now, take the examples. First, he is reading a novel. Here the subject is he, the verb is reading, and the object is a novel. So the passive form will be, a novel is being read by him. Now the next example, Ram was writing a letter. Here the subject is Ram, verb is was writing, and the object is a letter. So the passive form will be, a letter was being written by Ram. Look at the third example, we were playing cricket. So the passive form will be, cricket was being played by us. Now take the note. So far we have learned the passive form of the present continuous and past continuous. Now the note is, in modern English, the passive form of a future continuous tense is not in practice. Now take a look at the fourth point. Here we are going to learn about the objects that are not used as subjects in the passive. Let's see. Note, the reflexive objects and the factative objects are not used as subjects in the passive voice. We know the reflexive objects are actually the reflexive pronouns that act as an object to some verb in a sentence. See, for example, he killed himself. Here the subject is he, the verb is killed, which is in past tense, and its object is himself. See, here the object is a self pronoun. These are called reflexive objects. Now, these are not used as subjects in the passive voice. If we convert the sentence into passive as the following, see, himself was killed by him. It's a wrong expression. Now, the correct answer will be, he was killed by himself. Now, the factative object, the objects that are used as a complement in general. See, they made me captain. Here the subject is they, the verb is med, the object is me, and captain is another object, rather a complement to the object me. So, these objects are not used as subjects in the passive form. See, if we convert this sentence into passive as, captain was made me by them, that's a wrong example. So, the correct one is, I was made captain by them. Now, here we are going to learn the passive forms of the intransitive verbs. Take the note. The intransitive verbs do not take objects with them normally, so they do not have their passive form. But in three special cases, the intransitive verbs are used transitively, that means with some objects. So, naturally, in these special cases, they have their passive forms. Now, let's see, what are they? Point number one. If the intransitive verb takes a cognate object with it. Now, see, he ran a race. Here, the subject is he, the verb is ran, and the object is race. He ran what? He ran a race. Now, see, the object race is called a cognate object because the object and the verb are of the same meaning. Now, the passive form of this sentence is a race was run by him. Now, take the second example. He slept a sound sleep. Here, the verb is slept and its object is a sound sleep. The case is the same. Here, the object and the verb are of the same meaning. So, the passive form of this sentence is a sound sleep was slept by her. Now, take the next example. I dreamt a beautiful dream. The passive form is a beautiful dream was dreamt by me. Now, come to the second point. If the intransitive verb is used as a causative verb. See, for example, she walks the child. Here, the subject is see. The verb is walk and the object is the child. Now, the passive form is the child is walked by her. Now come to the final point. If the intransitive verb is used as a group verb. See, for example, he laughed at the lame man. You know, the verb laugh is an intransitive. It doesn't have any object with it. But in this sentence, it is used here as a group verb and it bears a different meaning. Here, laugh at means to mock. So the subject is laugh. The verb is laughed at, that actually means to mock, and its object is the lame man. Now, it can be converted into passive. See, first comes the object, the lame man, then the be verb was, then the PP form of the verb laughed at, next by, and finally him. Take another example. We agreed to his proposal. Here the subject is we. Now the verb is agreed to. Now the object is his proposal. So, the passive form of this sentence is, his proposal was agreed to by us. So dear, so far it was our second session on the topic the learning voice. Now, in our next session, we are going to learn the voice change of the interrogative and imperative sentences. So, practice well at home and stay tuned with us for more. Thank you.